Hello and welcome to Hinkley Point C. I'm here today with Ashley Daniels and we will be talking about lifting. Hi Ashley.
How are you doing? You okay?
Yeah, good, thank you. So tell me a little bit about your role.
Yeah, magnificent view here today in the sun, in the winter time, so we're fortunate. We can see multiple tower cranes, crawler cranes. It's paramount part of the project why we have cranes. It allows us to simultaneously work in two work areas right there in the cold face where the work's been undertaken, and we can precast off-site or on-site, and we can allow them to lift into that so we can section build in the work area or we can precast. So it's paramount we do that.
Looking around, the skyline is full of cranes. Can you tell us why they're important to Hinkley Point C and why they're used on the project?
Yeah, the key to the HPC project is it allows us to lift equipment, material into the work area. Also, it allows two simultaneous working areas to happen. So you've got the coal face, as we call it, where they're out operating and undertaking the works. And then it allows for us to pre-engineer, construct off-site, and allows us to bring elements for us to be lifted into position.
What's the counterweight and why is it used?
The counterweight on a crane is positioned normally at the rear end of the crane. Greater the counterweight, the greater capacity dependent on the crane's capability. As you see, big Carl's got 52 counterweights on the back of him, weighing up to 5,200 ton. Each container weighing 10 ton and 100 ton when full. So yeah, that's the counterweight.
Lift radius and lift capacity, how are these related?
So each crane will have a lifting capacity dependent on the radius, and that works within the crane and its telemetry, and it'll know on its capacity at set radiuses. That's all predetermined by the manufacturer, and it's in the manufacturer's specification sheet as well. So if you can think of the crane, it'll have its capacity of a radius of 100. It will be able to lift one unit there, for instance, and then the further it comes in, it's the greater units it can lift. So like I said, from 100 metres, maybe one unit, and from 50 metre radius, it could have 10 units. So greater the capacity, lower the radius, dependent on the crane.
If you had to pick one thing, what would be the best part of your job?
So I really enjoy my job. Every day is different. Every day on such a magnificent project like it is challenging, it's got its demands, but you feel a sense of achievement each time you walk out the gate, looking back and looking at the crane. So
if someone wanted to get involved in lifting, what subjects would you encourage them to study hard at school and college?
Maths and English would be the key topics I would focus on. Maths enabling you to undertake calculations, how the load is going to be lifted, the weight of the load and the radiuses and the ground bearing pressures and so on. And then English is key, and it's key in any subject, but key for that, putting the documentation together, making sure it's precise and it stipulates what you're going to undertake or the lifting.
Thanks for your time today, Ashley.
Thank you.
I hope you've enjoyed the video and learning a little bit more about crane operations and lifting here at Hinkley Point C.